terms of photoaging, the cause of photoaging now is quite well established. It is because of the chronic exposure to sunlight. As we all know, sunlight, UV specifically, with short exposure, there are acute changes. Erythema, tanning reaction, those are the acute changes that can occur following UV exposure. But in terms of photoaging, is a reflection of chronic sun exposure over the years. We get wrinkling, we get thickening of the skin, we get the actinic keratosis, and of course the development of skin cancers. Those are known to be the side effect of chronic sun exposure. Specifically in terms of the photoaging, aside from wrinkling, one can get also the development of freckles, lentigines on the skin. One can develop the tanning response, that the skin becomes very thick, we get very leathery type of appearance. Those are all reflective of chronic sun exposure. Then in the other extreme, obviously, the development of skin cancer. In terms of the causes of photoaging, it is known that UV plays a significant role. It is also now known, just new data coming out, that visible light may also play a role on that. Let me start with ultraviolet light first. Ultraviolet B and ultraviolet A is now known to both cause photoaging changes. Specifically, the UVA would induce reactive oxygen species. It has been known that reactive oxygen species generation could participate in the photoaging process. More importantly, both UVB and UVA would also induce the development of matrix metalloproteinases. So essentially, these are protein enzymes specifically that breaks down collagen. So with each sun exposure, you get the development of matrix metalloproteinases. It breaks down the collagen, resulting in the fragmentation of collagen. So with repeated exposure, there are more and more collagen that is becoming abnormal, becoming fragmented. That's how wrinkles develop. So that is the cause in terms of pathophysiology of why people get wrinkles following sun exposure. With chronic exposure, you get more and more wrinkling. The new data, some of them actually developed in our own, by our own group, is looking at visible light. Visible light is the one that we all need for general illumination purposes. For the longest time, visible light is thought to be inert, aside from we all need it for daily activities, we all need it for life. But now we have been able to show that visible light would induce tanning response, especially in darker skin individuals. So that is the acute effect of visible light that had not been well described until now. And also, we're now developing methodologies to look at the visible light in terms of photoaging changes, and we found that visible light can also induce matrix metalloproteinases, so very similar to UVB and UVA. Clearly, there's an early part of the study, and there are more that needs to be done. The other part that is related to this is that in the spectrum of sunlight, we do know also there is infrared radiation. Infrared is the one that gives the warmth. When you go outside, you feel the warmth because sunlight, there is infrared. It is known also infrared can induce also matrix metalloproteinases, the same enzyme that I've mentioned before. So it is essentially the causes in terms of photoaging, wrinkling formation. It is UV, UVB and UVA, suggestion, visible light, definitely also good data on infrared radiation.